गाइस, वेलकम टू द एग्जाम रैट। सो लेट्स जस्ट स्टार्ट विद आवर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 10, सर्कल्स, विच बिलोंग्स टू द यूनिट नंबर 4, ज्योमेट्री इटसेल्फ। ओके, सो बिफोर स्टार्टिंग विद द चैप्टर, लेट मी जस्ट टेल यू दैट प्लीज गो थ्रू आवर वेबसाइट एंड सब्सक्राइब। यू विल ऑल्सो बी गेटिंग द PDF नोट्स, एंड इन केस ऑफ एनी डाउट्स एंड क्वेरीज यू कैन जस्ट कमेंट बिलो, एंड मी एंड माई टीम कैन गेट बैक टू यू व्हेनेवर यू आर इन नीड और लाइक यू want something or in case of any queries or doubts. Okay, so basically let's start with our chapter number 10, that is circles. Okay, so basically in this chapter what we will learn about is we'll learn about the circles, we'll learn about the paths of circles, we'll also learn about certain new terms of the circles like arc, segment, sector, which you people don't know. Okay, then we can also have to learn about certain theorems of the circle, chords. Okay, so this is we are going to learn in this particular chapter. So let's see that what is a circle and what are the different terminologies that we have to study in this particular chapter, right? So basically, what is a circle? The locus of the point that are the same distance from the center. Basically, it is, for example, these are the dotted, okay, so basically there is a center, let it be O. So basically, what is the circle means that these dots, they are present at the equal distance from the center. It means that this particular distance of these dots from the center must be equal to anything. For example, if it is equals to A, then all the distances should be equal to A. Okay, so this is what we called as a circle, when the distance between the center and these dots or the locus of the point is always equal. Let us consider these distances. So basically, all these distances, they are equal. The distance between the center and the locus of points are equal. That's what we called as a circle, right? We always know that what is a circle? A circle is a 2D shape. Okay, point to remember is don't ever compare circle with the sphere. Sphere is something different. It is a 3D structure, where a circle is a 2D structure which we can cut with the help of the paper. Okay, so here you will know about what is a circle, right? Then there are certain terminologies related to the circle. The first is the interior of the circle, the second is the on the circle, and third is the exterior. Okay, so basically, as the name suggests, what does that interior term means? As you know, that interior means that something that is present inside, right? Interior means something that is present inside, right? Now, as the terminology suggests, exterior means something that is present outside. Am I right? So, here, A is the point which is present inside the circle, that is why we called it as interior of the circle, right? B is the point which is present outside the circle, that is why we called it that B is the exterior of the circle. C is the point that lies on the circle, because it lies on the line of the circle, we called it that it is present on the circle, right? So let's move to the other terminologies which are related to the circle. Okay, so you people have already studied about this radius, diameter, circumference term. So we'll study about some other new terms like tangent, segment, sector, arc, chord. Tangent is not in your syllabus, basically in class 9th. Tangent will be in class 10th, but I'll just give you a brief intro. I'll give you just a brief intro about the terminologies of the circle, right? That what is something in something, I'll explain you everything. Okay, so the first terminology is circumference. You know, let's just suppose this is a circle. So in this circle, दिस इज द पैरामीटर. व्हाट इज अ पैरामीटर? अ पैरामीटर इज बेसिकली द फॉर एग्जांपल द एरिया. एरिया इज बेसिकली द शेडेड रीजन और द रीजन विच इज कवर्ड, दैट इज कॉल्ड एरिया. बट द पैरामीटर इज जस्ट द फेंसिंग ऑफ आउटसाइड लाइन ऑफ द सर्कल. दिस इज द आउटसाइड लाइन ऑफ द सर्कल. वेन वी जस्ट फेंस इट, देन वी कॉल्ड इट एज द सर्क्यूम्फेरेंस, राइट? So what is a circumference? It is the distance around the circle. It is not area, it is this distance is what we called as the circumference, right? This distance we called as the circumference, where the fencing can be done. Like this particular line portion is known as the circumference. Okay, now the radius. So basically I already told you in my previous slide that circle is something in which the distance between the center and the locus of the points are always equal. So radius is the distance between the center and the locus of the points, right? This is what we called as the radius. That particular distance is radius, and radius is always equal from each and every point. Now this is, for example, this is a circle. This outside area, this outside distance is the circumference. This is the center. Center to the locus of point distance is called as the radius. Now the diameter. The diameter is basically the largest distance, between the two points of the circle. So obviously the largest distance is something which will lie in the center. So this is the diameter, or this is also the diameter. This is the diameter. Basically the radius is equals to half of the diameter. These are the things that you have studied in your earlier classes, but let's just pay attention to the other terminologies which are new to you. Okay, so our other terminology is chord. So what is a chord? Basically, let's suppose this is a circle. This is the line which is joining the two points of the circle, but it is not passing through the center of the circle, that we called as the chord, right? The straight line joining the two points on the circumference of the circle is known as the chord, and the diameter is also the chord, but we can call the diameter is the largest chord. The diameter is the largest chord of the circle, right? This is what we called as the chord. Okay, now the second thing is arc. What is arc? Arc, you know that this is the arc, the part of the circumference, the small part or the section of the circumference is known as the arc. Okay, the small part of the circumference. I'm writing here so that you people could better understand, and whenever you will see this video and having your PDF notes, you will be able to retain and you will be able to remember that what I have taught in the class. Okay, now the sector. What is a sector? A sector is basically the section of the circle which is bounded by two radii and an arc. Okay, so let's just suppose that this is a circle, this is a radii, this is also another radii, and this is an arc. So this particular portion is called as the sector. You can say that this is also the sector. So this is known, since it is the larger portion of sector, that is why it is called as major sector. You people don't have to worry about this sector thing in class 9. This is more importantly will come in class 10th. So this is the minor sector, right? Now segment, the section of the circle bounded by the arc and the chord. So let's just suppose this is a circle, this is a chord, this is the arc. So this is called minor segment, and this is called the major segment. Am I right? The last thing is the tangent. What is a tangent? It is a line which touch the circumference once at a given point. This is the circle, There is a line drawn to the circle which touches the circle to a particular point, and this is what we called as the tangent, right? Okay, now this is a semicircle. You know about the semicircle? The half of the circle is known as the semicircle. There is a new term here, that is a quadrant. What do you mean by the quadrant? As I told you in quadrilateral, that quad means four. It means quadrant is, like semicircle is half of the circle, quadrant is 1/4 of circle. This particular part is the quadrant. For example, this is a pizza. When it is divided in four parts, this particular part is known as the quadrant. Am I right? Okay, this is known as the quadrant, and we have studied about the quadrant in the coordinate geometry and linear equations, right? So this is the same quadrant. Okay, now let's move to the another slide, that is the theorems which are related to the circle. In the chapter number 10, there are total 12 theorems that you people have to study, so you have to pay attention and be careful for whatever I am teaching here. Okay, so the first theorem is theorem 10.1. What does the theorem 10.1 says? So basically, according to theorem 10.1, equal chords of the circle subtend equal angles at the center. So what we are given, that AB and CD are the two chords which are equal. So AB and CD are equal, so they subtend the equal angles at the center. We have to prove that angle AOB is equals to angle COD, right? So basically, in triangle AOB and in triangle COD, AB is equals to CD, that is already given, right? Now AO is equals to OD. Why? Because it is the radius, the distance between the center and the circumference part. Now OB is also equals to OC. Why? Because it is also the radius. So by SSS congruency rule, we can say that triangle AOB is congruent to triangle DOC. Am I right? Okay, so by the CPCT term, we can say that angle AOB is equals to angle DOC. Hence, we are proved with the first theorem of chapter number 10, that is circles. Okay, now let's move forward towards the theorem number 2. According to the theorem number 2, if the angle subtended, this is just the converse of theorem 10.1. As I told you in my last chapter, that most of the theorems, they are the converse of the other theorems. So here is also the same thing, that if the angles here, the angles subtended are equal. So what is given here, that angle AOB equals to angle DOC, that term is given here. Okay, and what we have to prove is, we have to find out, or we have to prove that AB is equals to CD. This is just the converse of the theorem number 10.1. So let's move forward towards the other theorems, that is theorem 10.3. So according to theorem 10.3, the perpendicular from the center bisects the chord. Okay, so basically this is a circle, right? This is a circle. So this is the center of the circle. This is the chord which we can name as AB. So according to this theorem, according to theorem 10.3, the perpendicular drawn from the center of the circle, it means this is the perpendicular, they bisect the chord. So it, according to this theorem, A, let this point be P. So AP is equals to PB. Right, now the theorem number, come to the theorem number 4. Basically, theorem number 4 is just as usual, the converse of theorem 10.3. Am I right? According to theorem number 10.4, okay, so what is given, that basically AM is equals to MB. And to prove is, angle AMO is equals to 90 degree. This is what we have to prove, and this is what is already given in the question. So basically, theorem 10.4 is the converse of theorem 10.3. So what does 10.3 theorem says? It says that perpendicular from the center bisects the chord, and theorem 10.4 says that when there is a line which bisects the chord, then that line is always perpendicular to the chord. It makes the, what do you mean by perpendicular here? Perpendicular means that it makes the angle equals to 90 degree. This is what we meant by perpendicular, right? So we have to prove that this particular angle is equals to 90 degree, right? Now let's move to theorem number 5. There is only one and only one circle passing through three given non-collinear points. Okay, so basically there are three non-collinear given points A, B, C. Let's just suppose this is the, okay, this is the circle. There are the three points A, B and C. Okay, so they say that there are only one circle passing through this three given non-collinear points. Why they are non-collinear points? Let's just go back. What is non-collinear points? The points which do not come in a straight line, don't lie in straight line, they are known as the non-collinear points, right? Now this is the particular, what we have to prove is there is only one circle formed. So since O, there is a, O is the point which lies in the center, O lies on the perpendicular bisector of AB. Okay, so this is the AB and O, they lies on the, this is the perpendicular bisector on this particular chord from the theorem 10.3. okay, so since it is a perpendicular bisector here, so this, let this be like let this be anything. So basically by this, OB will be equals to OC. Why OB is equals to OC? Because they are the radius, they are the radius, that is why OB is equals to OC. Now since O lies on perpendicular, the O here, they also lies on perpendicular bisector of the BC. So by this, OA will be equals to OB equals to OC. So O is basically equidistant from both A, B and C, right? So if a circle is drawn with center O and radius OA, the circle will pass through B and C also. Why so? Why this happen? Because OA is equals to OB is equals to OC. It means all of them are radius. It means if OA is the distance, if the circle is passing through OA, then they will also pass through these points, right? If they will not pass through these points, how they can be equal? So if they are equal, it means the circle will be passed through these particular points, right? So O is the only point equidistant from A, B, C. So that is why only one circle can be drawn from three non-collinear points. Now let's move to theorem number 10.6. The theorem 10.6 says that equal chords of the circle are equidistant from the center. What does that mean? This is a circle, this is a point, there are the two chords, the given term is, let this be AB, let this be CD, right? So AB is equals to CD is given. Okay, so this theorem says that this distance between this and this, like this is P and this is Q, so this says that OP will be equal to OQ. This according to the theorem, right? So theorem kehti hai that when the two chords are equal to each other, then they're also equidistant from the centers, right? Now our next theorem is theorem 10.7. So let's move to theorem 10.7. What does this theorem actually say? According to this theorem, the chords equidistant from the centers of the circle are equal in length. So you can easily see that this particular theorem is the converse of theorem 10.6, right? This particular theorem is the converse of theorem 10.6, because the theorem 10.6 says, according to theorem 10.6, it says that when the chords are of equal length, when the chords are of equal length, they are equidistant from the centers. Right, so this is basically the converse of theorem 10.6, because this theorem says that if the chords are equidistant, then the chords are equal to each other. Right, what you have to do is you just have to take the two triangles, you have to just find that whether they are congruent or not, and when they will be congruent, you just have to, by with the help of CPCT, you can easily prove that the particular theorem is true. Okay, now the theorem 10.8 is the angle subtended by an arc at the center is double the angle subtended by it at any point on the remaining part of the circle. Okay, so basically this says, for example, this is a circle, this is the arc, there is certain angle which is subtended by this arc. So at the center, suppose this is something x. Okay, so this arc, if form any angle at any other part of the circle, if this arc form any other angle at the another part of the circle, then that particular angle will be equal to half of the angle present at the center. This is the angle at center, right? This is theorem number 10.8. Let's move to theorem 10.9. So according to theorem 10.9, the angles in the same segment of the circle are equal. So what do you mean by the segment? Actually, I told you about segment, that what is a segment and what is the sector. Okay, so this is basically the segment and this is the segment. So these are the angles which are present in the same segment. That is why the angles in the same segment of circle are equal. Like you can see there, the angle A will be equals to angle B because they lies in the same segment. Am I right? Now theorem number 10.10. Okay, so what does theorem 10.10 suggest? That if a line segment joining the two points subtend equal angle at two other points lying on the same side of the line containing line segment, the four points lie on the circle, that is, they are coincyclic. Okay, so this is something like, if a line segment joining the two points subtend equal angle at two other points. Okay, this is the line segment joining the two points. Okay, this is the line segment joining the two points. They subtend, these are the two angles which are subtended by the line segment at two other points. Okay, so on the two other points lying on the same side of the line containing line segment, the four points lies on the circle. So there are the four points lies on the circle. These four points are considered to as the concyclic. Okay, we can call them as cyclic. This is theorem 10.10. Let's move forward towards another theorem, that is theorem 10.11. Okay, so what does theorem 10.11 says? Theorem 10.11 says that it is basically the cyclic quadrilateral theorem. What is a cyclic quadrilateral mean? Okay, so basically a cyclic quadrilateral is something in which a quadrilateral is inscribed inside the circle. Okay, so basically a quadrilateral is inscribed, that is present inside, that is what we meant by the inscribed term, inside, that is present, quadrilateral is inscribed in the circle. That is what we called as the cyclic quadrilateral. So the opposite angles of the cyclic quadrilateral are supplementary. That is what they mean, that angle ABD, let this be 1, angle ACD, let this be 2. So this is the cyclic quadrilateral. The angle, the opposite angles of the cyclic quadrilateral are supplementary. Okay, this is what they meant by this theorem. According to theorem 10.11, angle B plus angle C is equals to 180 degree. That is what we meant by supplementary, right? Like this is the term. Okay, let's just suppose let's I will explain you by drawing a diagram that how what it actually mean. So basically, let's just suppose we are drawing a cyclic quadrilateral having a circle, and a quadrilateral is inscribed in this particular circle. It can be of any shape, but it have to be four-sided, right? Let it be A, B, C, D. So according to this particular theorem, angle A plus angle C is equals to 180 degree, right? And angle B plus angle D is also equals to 180 degree. This is what it meant by this theorem, right? The theorem 10.12 is the last theorem of this particular chapter, circles. So according to this, if the sum of the pair of the opposite angle of quadrilateral is 180 degree, it is cyclic. You can see that theorem 10.12 is the converse of theorem 10.11. According to this theorem, if angle A plus C is equals to 180 degree is already given, and we have to prove that it is a cyclic quadrilateral, right? This is end with the theorems of this particular chapter. Now we'll begin with certain questions so that you people could better understand that how the circle chapter is and how you can understand about this particular. So let's just start with the another question or with the questions related to the circle chapter, right? So basically, we will just start with the questions. So first of all, we'll begin with the first question, that is the two circles of radii 5 cm and 3 cm, they are intersecting each other at two points and the distance between their center is 4 cm. This is the distance, this is between the center is 4 cm. Find the length of the common chord. This will be the common chord AB. The figure is something like this. This is a circle with 5 cm, right? This is the another circle with O dash, and this is 3. This is the distance between the two centers, that is 4. We have to find this particular length. This is the particular length that we have to find out. Okay, now find the length of the common chord. So we know that OA, this is the OA term, and this is O dash A. We know that OA is equals to OB. We know that OA is equals to OB equals to 5 cm because they are the radius of the circles. Similarly, O dash A will be equals to O dash B equals to 3 cm because they are also the radius of the another smaller circle, right? Now OO dash will be the perpendicular bisector of this chord. You know this is the right angle and this is the chord. So OO dash is basically the perpendicular bisector. So we get to know that AC will be equals to CB. By using the certain theorem, we came to know that AC equals to CB, right? Now it is given that OO dash is already equals to 4 cm. This is also given. Now what we have to see is let OC equals to X. Okay, this is the OC thing, let it be X. Okay, therefore OC dash will be 4 minus X. It is very simpler. By putting this, we can say that OC dash is 4 minus X, right? Now in triangle OAC, since it is a right angle triangle, we can say by using the Pythagoras theorem, OA square equals to AC square plus OC square. Am I right? Now OA square is given as 5 square equals to AC square is not at all given. Whereas OC square, we can just put the OC square as X square. Yeah, right. Then AC square will came out to be 25 minus X square. Similarly, in triangle O dash C, AC, we find out that AC square minus X square minus 7 plus 8X is equals to equation, right? This is the particular equation. So what we have to do is from equation 1 and 2, we have to find out the AC square value. We'll just equate them. After equating, we'll see that 25 minus X square equals to minus X square minus 7 plus 8X. We can just cancel out this. Now after taking it there, we get 8x equals to 32 and x equals to 4. So basically, the length of the x is basically what we have, x is OC. Okay, so we have found out the x equals to OC. OC is equals to x. After that, we know that AC square is equals to, we have to find the length of common chord, right? So first of all, we have to find out the length of AC. So AC square is equals to 25 minus 16 equals to 9, or AC is equals to plus minus 3. Am I right? So that is what we get as the AC. And from this particular thing that we know that OO dash is the perpendicular bisector. So AC will be equals to CB, right? So this whole AB will be equals to 3 plus 3 equals to 6 centimeters. This is the length of the common chord. So here we can just write it down as that AC will be equals to 25 minus 4 square, or AC is equals to 9, or AC equals to 3. Now AB is equals to AC plus CB equals to 3 plus 3 equals to 6 centimeters. That is the answer of this particular question. Let's move towards the another question, that is question number 2. Okay, so if a line intersects two concentric circles, what do you mean by concentric circle? When a circle is present inside a circle, then we called it as the concentric circles. Okay, they have the same center, they are drawn from the, what are concentric circle? I'll just write it down here. With same center but different radius. This is a very brief intro about the concentric circles, right? So there are two concentric circles and a line AD is intersecting them. So while with center O at A to B and C and D, prove that AB equals to CD. Okay, so how will we just prove it? We just have to draw a construction here, right? OM perpendicular to BC. This is a concentric circle. This is O, right? This is A, this is B, this is C, and this is D. This is a particular line. We have to draw a M point here. OM is perpendicular to AD, right? Now if OM is perpendicular to this particular thing, so AM will be equals to MD, right? And BM will also be equals to CM. Let it be 1, let it be 2. Subtracting 2 from 1, we'll be getting AM minus BM equals to DM minus CM. And we'll get AB equals to CD. Hence, proved. This is the whole question about the circles, right? Let's move to the another question. So basically in this question is, if the circles are drawn taking two sides of the triangle as diameter. Okay, basically if they are drawn taking two sides, this is the triangle. You are taking this as diameter. Then how will you draw a circle like this? This is something you will draw that circle, right? And by taking this as the diameter, you will draw the circle like this only, right? So prove that the point of intersection of these circle lie on the third side. We have to prove that this particular point of intersection lies on the third side. Okay, now what we have to do is, you can just see in the picture, angle ADB is 90 degree. Because these are the angles in semicircle. Similarly, angle ADC is also equals to 90 degree. Okay, now ADB plus ADC will be equals to 180. Since BDC is a straight line, how can you prove that BDC is a straight line? Basically, angle ADB is 90 degree because it is the angle of semicircle, right? For the similar reason, angle ADC will also be equals to 90 degree, right? If we add both of them, we'll get angle ADB plus angle ADC equals to 180 degree. So by the linear pair theorem, when there is a straight line, when the angle formed by the straight line is 180 degree, it is a linear pair. So in that particular case, if 180 degree is the angle, then line should be straight. Obviously, if the line is not straight, then how can the angle can be 180 degree, right? So the line should be straight. So if it lies in the straight line, it means that T lies, D is the point lying on BC. Am I clear? So let's move to the last question of the chapter number 10, that is circles. In this particular figure, A, B, C are the three points on a circle with center O, such that angle BOC is 30, angle AOB is 60. If D is the point, T is any point, the point on the circle other than the arc ABC. Find angle ADC. You have to find this particular angle. To find out this angle, we have to draw the picture. Let's draw the picture in more sophisticated way, right? So this is the circle, right? This is AD. This is like this. This figure is something like this. Right. So now what we have to do is, this is angle 60 degree. This angle is 30 degree. We have to find out this particular angle. So how will we find out is angle ADC. Okay, so particularly we have to find out angle ADC will be equals to half of angle AOC. Remember the last theorem, according to theorem 10.12, the angle which is subtended at the center is always double of the angle which is subtended by the same segment at the other point of the arc or the circumference. So basically half of angle AOC. Now we are not given angle AOC, so angle AOC will be 60 plus 30. Right, so angle ADC will be equals to 45. This is very easy chapter. So you can see that circle is like this only. So like this, you can just solve the questions out. And if you will not be able to do something, you can just tell me, or you can just like comment down below, and me and my team will get back to you. So this is how the things can be done. Okay, so I hope you people enjoyed this session, and I hope you people could better understand about the circles, terminologies, theorems, and how to solve the questions too. It is very important to know the criteria to solve the problems and to solve the questions. It is very important to apply the particular theorems in the questions. Like people just can learn the theorems, but they don't know how to apply the theorems. That is why I am solving the questions here, so that you people could know that how we can just apply a particular theorem in a particular question, right? So I hope you all enjoyed. Thank you for the day. Have a nice day.